Hey guys, welcome to today's video. Please do not mind all of this, okay? We're gonna work on it. That's why we're here. That's why I'm filming, because we're gonna work on this. We're gonna work on the hair. I have to finish tying my top. Listen, I have to go to the doctor's office, okay? I have to go to the doctor's office, but I wanna look presentable. At least as presentable as I can. You see this? My eyes are swollen. I've been a little on the sick side. So a little bit of makeup is gonna make me feel better. And then obviously going to the doctor and probably getting a prescription if whatever I have going on in here is no bueno. You know what I mean? So in order to achieve feeling good, feeling amazing, and like really like doing myself up, we will be utilizing the August Tribe Beauty Box. Now they do send this to me in PR, and I also got an email, so I want to give you guys an update because they did increase their prices. I know, I'm sorry. I gotta keep it real, they increased their prices. The box will continue to be a bi-monthly box, but the price is increasing to $39.99, and they will continue to provide the free shipping. Of course, the free shipping is only for the US. I believe they now have a US-based warehouse, which is amazing. Prices for Canada are also $39.99, but they will have a $2.99 shipping fee. Internationally, $39.99, but then there's a $7.99 shipping fee, which I think is awesome. Like, if you want the box and you live internationally, all you gotta do is pay the $8 and still get access to the box, because, I mean, not a lot of boxes ship, like, internationally, you know? So, okay, so I wanna show you the items really quickly, and then we're gonna dive on it and try to fix this mess that we have going on. The first item included in my box is a lip oil. Now I normally say hell no to lip oils because I don't find that they work, but I'm gonna give this one a try. Why? Because I'm feeling like it. That's why. Honestly, that's why. Because I'm feeling like it. My lips are shooting color. You know, with this head cold that I've been having, I've been feeling kind of funky. Okay, my eyes are swollen. A, because of the congestion. And B, I've been crying because I don't like being sick. Okay, I never get sick. So this is by the brand Julep Beauty. It is the Hint of Pink Transforming Lip Oil. It creates a custom... Oh, I'm glad I decided to use this. So this is supposed to create a custom color for my lips. Of course, I want to wear lipstick, so I'm only gonna use this to like hydrate my lips for now. But this is cool. It's clear. Let's apply her. I think I really wanna, well, let's see. Let's see what lip color it creates for me. How long does it take to create a custom lip color? Okay, so the lip oil reacts to my unique pH balance, wrapping my pout in a perfect shade of sheer pink. I mean, I could kind of see it. Mm-hmm. It is paraben-free, vegan, clean beauty, cruelty-free, and SLS-free. Why am I still applying some? I think my lips are drenched enough. Okay, we'll see. It kind of looks, if you hear Tyne singing in the background, I'm sorry, she's like in home world always. She's always singing. I can kind of see a hint of pink, but not like too, too pink. So, oh my God, my hair is annoying me. Ever since I started wearing these hair extensions, my hair, as it is annoying. I'm sorry. All right, so that's that lip oil. It has a little bit of like a minty kind of going on. Cool, fine. The next item is this over here, and I saw it and I was like, would I? Maybe, maybe not. And then I was like, why not? I should. This is the W&E dry brush. This retails for $52. I don't know why, but it does apparently. This is what it looked like, and to me, $52, really? Really? However, it says this dry brush is made with natural beech wood, combining rubber nodules and natural bristles to help stimulate the lymphatic system. It encourages the removal of toxins while exfoliating and smoothing your skin. Use it weekly. So this became a fad. It became a thing. I never like jumped on the bandwagon, but since I have this, I might. So apparently, to dry exfoliate, you just kind of do this all over your skin, and then pop yourself in the shower, and then when you come out, apply your oil, apply your lotion, and apparently your skin is supposed to feel amazing. Like, you should notice a difference immediately, but then as you do it, like on an ongoing basis, once or twice a week, you're supposed to feel a drastic difference. I don't know about that, but people like have raved about this for so long. So I think this is really cool. I don't know about the price point. It's not Tribe Beauty's fault, okay? They're not the makers. But $52 for something like this is kind of crazy to me. Mm. Then we have a Mirabella eyeshadow primer. Okay, I thought it was like an eyelid primer, like a lash primer. I was gonna say no. But if this is an eyeshadow primer, this is supposed to allow your makeup last forever. Not forever, but you know, like crease proof, crease resistant, that kind of thing. Okay, so it has a little bit of a pigment to it. When you blend it out, kind of shears away, but you can kind of still see. Okay, so you get one of these, and with that, you get an eyeshadow palette, which I'm excited for. It is the Bibella Cosmetics Life in Pastel Eyeshadow palette. If Ty sees this, she's gonna want it. Look at this. Okay, I'm not sure about what the pigmentation is gonna look like, but I'm kind of excited for the like pops of color. I think they're really cute. And then you have a product by The Makeup Drop. It is their body applicator. Now, this here, you can technically use for anything. You can use it to apply your skincare, self-tanners, sun tanning lotion, that kind of thing. At least that's what it's described to be able to do. However, if you've been in the makeup community or a follower of the makeup community for the past, 5 years? This was a huge thing, 4 years ago. Come on now, you know you recognize this. It was like one of those jelly applicators, and everyone jumped on the bandwagon, including yours truly. And basically they would use this to apply like their foundation and blend it out and then their concealer. And I didn't like it very much. At least the one that I purchased, I did not like very much. I don't self-tan, and I'm not gonna apply any tanning lotion or like, you know, lotion right now, but I can use this for makeup, which is what I'm gonna use it for. You know what? We're gonna use this for makeup. We're gonna see if I change my mind so many years later and whether or not I like this for foundation, because technically you can use this for anything. All right, let's go ahead. First things first, we're gonna try the little jelly saturation. I'm gonna use this foundation by Ofra Cosmetics. Why? Because I love them, okay? I'm gonna do one pump. I don't really wanna like overdo it because my eyes are so swollen today. Like so swollen. So I'm gonna take my little jelly applicator like this. And there's like a flat side and then there's like a poofy side. I'm gonna use the poofy side. And I'm gonna do this just so that I can blend. The good thing about this is it will not absorb your foundation like at all. So you're not wasting product. I just feel, you know what? We're gonna do this, whatever. Let's see, the thing, I needed two pumps. I usually do two pumps. What am I doing? What, girl? I think I'm gonna end up having to go in with a sponge to get a proper blend here. Because technically people were doing this, but it wasn't doing anything, or it was hyped as in it's working. Girl, it wasn't, okay? It wasn't. You know what? I don't even need to go in with a sponge. I think it's okay. It's pretty good. Let me show you what it does to concealers. Now, of course, there were definitely people who absolutely loved it. I just was not one of them. But I don't mind showing them to you guys and kind of reminiscing a little bit, you know? Now, this was good for the under eye because it wouldn't take, like, your concealer out. You know what I'm saying? But it's just, I don't know, for me the blend has always been weird. Again, they included this so that you can use it with like skincare and stuff, but I know I'm not gonna use it for skincare, so we're gonna reminisce like I said. Okay, now let's try the primer on my puffy lids. Okay, so once you blend it out, yeah, it kind of goes away so you don't see whether or not you missed the spot, which kind of sucks, but hopefully we didn't miss a spot. Now let's try this eyeshadow palette and see what it is all about. Hopefully it is amazing, okay? I'm gonna dip in, toh, bing, bing. I'm gonna dip into the pink. Okay, I'm gonna take that onto, okay. That is extremely pigmented. Let me tell you, I was not expecting that. I hope the camera's picking up how vibrant that is. I'm glad I padded it. Take whatever we have on the brush and blend out. All right, so the formula is slightly powdery, but again, it's still pigmented, so I'm not mad at it, and so far, I have no fallout. I tapped out just a little bit, not a lot. I'm gonna grab a clean brush and I feel like I wanna go into this, which purple? I think I'm gonna go into this purple. It looks kind of vibrant. It looks like it'll give me a lot of color payoff. So we will see. Tap out just in case. Let's see what happens. Okay, there's color coming off. Not as vibrant as I thought it was gonna come off, but there's purple there for sure. Okay, purple is here. Let's keep it simple and pretty. Okay, the purple definitely has some fallout though. I grabbed a clean brush and I'm just gonna blend out those edges. And I don't know if you can see it, but I definitely have some fallout down here. Not cute. I'm going to dip into this shade over here, which is beautiful. And I'm gonna tap that, I'm gonna tap that all over my lid. I feel like this is gonna make the look for sure. I love these pressed glitters like that. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and pop a good lash, a liner, finish off like this whole brow area, all that good stuff, a lippy, and I'll be right back. All right, guys, and here is the completed look now. Yes, I think this is a bit much for my doctor's office, but it's okay because it's me and I am a bit much, so I get it. All in all, I think the eyeshadow palette is cute. I do find that it's a little on the powdery side, but there's definitely some pigmentation that you can like get, and it is buildable. So for being an indie brand, and it's B. Bella, which sometimes their stuff can be hit or miss, I think it was actually pretty good, and I love the glitter. If anything, that glitter formula is beautiful. But yeah, those are all the items I received in my August Tribe Beauty Box variation. Let me know down below what you guys think, and if you're interested in joining Tribe Beauty Box, make sure you click the link in the description box. That's gonna take you over to their website and give you a discount as well. And with that, it is a wrap up for this video. Thank you so much for choosing to spend a few minutes out of your day with me. It really means a lot. Make sure you check out the videos that are coming here on screen. There are more unboxings, tutorials, how-tos, and all that good stuff. I know you guys are gonna absolutely love, and I'll see you guys over there. Bye, guys!